helping or hurting the Democratic cause. Beatola O'Rourke, the Democratic challenger for Ted Cruz's Senate seat, is saying he'd vote for impeachment and has been raising massive amounts of cash, more than any other Democratic candidate in the country. But just look at this recent controversial pro-Trump billboard posted in Maryland. Hey, liberals, you better get your guns if you try to impeach President Trump. In a recent New York Times op-ed piece, House Intelligence Committee ranking member Adam Schiff warned, don't take the bait on impeachment. He advises the Democrats instead focus, quote, on the economy, family, and a return to basic decency. The question is that enough of a plan to prevail? Joining me now, the perfect person to ask, the chair of the DNC, Tom Perez. You know, Mr. Secretary, I always appreciated when you were labor secretary, you graciously came on my SiriusXM radio program virtually every month to announce the new unemployment figures. I have to mention, you'd have loved a 3.9% unemployment figure as the labor secretary.
There, when Barack Obama made those courageous investments in the future, I'm glad to see that they continue to pay off, but there's so much more unfinished business here, Michael. And the reason that I saw your polls, and polls ebb and flow, but what hasn't ebbed and flowed since the beginning of 2017 has been Democratic enthusiasm and Democratic victories. We've been winning everywhere. We flipped over 40 seats in various races across the country, and we're winning because we're fielding good, great candidates. We are organizing everywhere, and most importantly, we're focusing on the issues that people care about. The unemployment rate is coming down, but wages continue to remain flat. People need a raise. That's what we're focused on. We're focused on health care because health care is a right for all and not a privilege for a few. And we're winning elections because Democrats believe that and Republicans don't. We're focused on making sure that people have access to quality education, whether it's in Oklahoma, West Virginia, Arizona, or across this country. And we're winning because we've been able to show that the Democrats are fighting for public education in our future, and the Republicans are not. And so that's what we're going to continue to do. Focus like a laser. Continue this momentum. In 2010, Michael, we got our butts kicked because the Republican enthusiasm was far more than the Democratic enthusiasm. The tables have turned. The last time we won the New Jersey and the Virginia gubernatorial elections in the same year was 2005. And you know what happened in 2006? Past is never prologue. But we continue to make progress.
I'm glad you bring up passion. I'm glad you bring up enthusiasm, because I want to make reference to that crazy billboard that I showed from Maryland. If, in fact, your Democratic House and Senate candidates say the I word, will they not drive passion on the Republican side of the ballot? In other words, do you want them talking about that issue or not?
Well, listen, the reason that there are some talking about that issue is because we have the most dangerous president in American history. And we've seen so many things happen that should never happen in the United States of America. What we've been focusing on and why we've been winning is we're focusing on, like Conor Lamb did in Pennsylvania. He focused on health care. He focused on pensions. He focused on the right to form a union. And that's why he won. We won in Virginia. We won in New Jersey because we focused on health care. We focused on the economy. We've been flipping seats in Oklahoma, four legislative victories in Oklahoma, because we focus there on public education. And we've been organizing everywhere. I'm so excited about the partnerships we've been able to build with the DNC and others in the ecosystem. And people are so energized. And that is how we are winning. And we're going to continue. My job is to help elect Democrats. We've been winning, and we're going to continue to win by focusing on these issues that people care about most.
Mr. Secretary, just yesterday I saw the Cook Political Report now saying the anti-Trump wave might turn out to be just a ripple. Do you deny that something has changed in the data in the last several weeks where the Democratic prospects seem to have dimmed? Are you looking at the same information we are?
Well, again, polls will ebb and flow between now and the election. What hasn't ebbed and flowed has been the Democratic enthusiasm and our victories. I mean, you look just last month. In Wisconsin, there was a Supreme Court race, and we were proud to have invested early in that race in organizing. Who would have thought that the candidate for that race, Rebecca Dallet, would have won. And she not only won, she won by 11 and a half points, Michael. She won Green Bay. She won in Western Wisconsin. She did fantastically in Milwaukee and Dane County. And she held her own basically all the way across the state. It was a referendum on Scott Walker. Scott Walker should be quaking in his boots. And so I, again, the polls will ebb and flow between now and the election. What hasn't ebbed and flowed has been the Democratic success. You look at Arizona in Congressional 8. We should have lost that seat by 20 points or 25 points in a normal year. And because Dr. Tepernetti was such a spectacular candidate and we were proud to have invested in the organizing there, she lost by a little bit under 5 points, and she's running again. And I think Kyrsten Sinema has a real shot of winning that Senate seat. And that's what we're doing in the new DNC. We're playing a long game. We're investing in organizing. We're investing early. And we've got candidates like Doug Jones last year who he didn't want to fight the culture wars. He wanted to improve the quality of life for average Alabamians. And that's what Democrats
are doing.
All right,
I think you're good. I think you've gotten in 20 names of your candidates so far. But I have a final question for you. I heard the point that you made about wages. I understand it. It's a legitimate point. But simplistically, is it fair to say you need to hope that James Carville is wrong in 2018, that this is not a year where it's about the economy, stupid? You need it to be more about all the distraction and noise and other issues and not the financial picture.
There are so many people I meet across this country, Michael, that are still suffering. People who want access to health care, and they know who's fighting for them, and they know who's not fighting for them. People in Pennsylvania, the coal miners, who are concerned about their pension security. The Republicans weren't helping them, and the Democrats are. People who want to make sure that their kids are well educated. In Oklahoma, kids go to school 4 days a week in many jurisdictions. Same thing in Kansas. That is why we are running competitive races in places like Kansas, Oklahoma, places you'd never would have imagined in the past. And we're organizing everywhere. We've returned to the 50-state party that we should have always been. And that's why when we focus on these bread and butter issues, that's why we're winning. And when we elect more Democrats, we can help dreamers finally. We can finally enact common sense gun safety measures. That's why I'm excited about moving forward. We've got a lot more work to do, no doubt about it. But I'd rather be the Democrats right now.
Mr. Secretary, thanks for coming back. I appreciate it.
Always a pleasure, Michael.
What are your thoughts? Tweet me at Smirkanish. Go to my Facebook page. I'll read more during the course of the program. Smirkanish, I told my Republican hubby, the Democrats have no message, and I believe the Dems won't win back both houses. They need something other than impeach and resist. And Hava Salida, the point that I just made to the head of the DNC, Tom Perez, is that talk of impeachment causes many people in those red states to say, hey, it's nothing but an effort to overturn the result of a legitimate election. And given 3.9% unemployment and given some of the attributes that the president can point to, North Korea coming to the table, they're going to be driven in their passion. That's why it's a touchy thing. You know, mentioning the I word may drive the Democratic base, but it might drive the Republican base more. Up ahead, the real Trump revolution is taking place far from the headlines about nukes and porn stars. He's quickly steering the judiciary to the right. Plus, a black Yale graduate student falls asleep on her dorm couch and somebody calls the cops.